All right, good morning, Iron Family. So, Saturday, I'm gonna lump the next two vlogs together, Saturday and Sunday, because it's similar stuff, same macros both days, and because I'm gonna be at the beach, I have a tendency, I know if you've been watching the vlogs for the past little bit, I have a tendency to not film anything because I get caught up surfing. So, we're gonna try to actually film this time. I always say that, every vlog, never happens, but since these are daily ones, I'll try to film a little bit more for these next 2 days. But macros, I will show you in a minute on my Fitness Pal, and whiteboard talks, I'm not bringing the whiteboard, so we'll just be doing a, like last video, just kind of commentary on some basic stuff, some more, you know, quick tips and tricks about peak week and some stuff that you should know if you're gonna attempt it. But without further ado, let's get on the road. Maria.
What?
Are you ready?
No, I can't find my bikini and I can't find my flip-flops.
Wow, you know, I was looking for like positive vibes on the
vlog. I'm ready, let's go.
So like we talked about, upping the carbs a little bit today and tomorrow, lowering the protein, fat can come up a little bit to accommodate for the extra carbs, but focusing more on carb loading, and then we'll really load them up Monday and Tuesday to fill out and then cut a little bit, refill for the weekend. But for this weekend, Saturday, Sunday, 190 carb, 50 fat, 155 protein. This is really hard because my finger's gigantic at this angle.
Also, I'm doing two sessions of HIIT cardio today and tomorrow, along with all the surfing I'll be doing, so that'll keep me active, but I have to get those two sessions of HIIT in. Like we talked about last video, cardio is very important, more so than the lifting here. At this point in the game, and I'll talk about this today, lifting is more to really get glycogen stores, get glycogen into the muscle. We're not looking to break down the muscle and build it anymore. That part should have been done already. Now that we're really in the end of this diet and we're right up by the show, we're just looking to not overly fatigue the muscle or burn out the glycogen stores. Instead, we're trying to create the stimulus to get glycogen in there and keep them full of glycogen up until the show, and then amplify that effect through our diet and through our water and sodium intake. So today's topic is going to be, how do we do that weight training wise? I'll run you through that.
He is such a dad. This is basically, he told me that I'm in charge of vlogging for the road trip and I'm too lazy to get out of the car, so I'm filming through a window.
I had like Corvette overload. There was a stingray across the street and then one pulled in and my head just kind of blew up.
Oh, that's what was happening. I had a whole commentary.
Oh, what was happening?
Yes, I called
you. No, watch, ready, watch. When we drive by this car, you'll see it.
Okay.
It's so nice. I'm telling you, Iron Family is gonna get black one of those with Iron Family and the logo down the side. It's gonna look awesome.
Okay, wait a minute.
New comment. Brand for everything.
Ask them to comment, see what they think of it.
Watch this car when we go by and tell me this would not look super cool. All blacked out with white Iron Family, and you guys haven't seen it yet, but we're rebranding it, so there's gonna be a whole new logo and everything down the side. It would be so cool. All right, look at this. So this one's red, but I'm talking blacked out, Iron Family logo down the side. That would look cool, I'm sorry. That would look badass. It's literally like just noon. I'm not gonna get out of the water all day, I swear. Today's whiteboard topic, no whiteboard, gonna be for peak week, how should you train? What are we gonna be doing training-wise in the gym? A lot of different people have different opinions on this, but the way that I'm looking at it, and I think the way that's medically backed the most, is going to be as follows. So, days 9 and 8, which was Thursday and Friday, continued that normal training from that week before. And finish that. For Saturday and Sunday, I'm gonna be taking 2 days off from weight training, let my body recruit from the week before, and just doing high intensity interval training cardio. Like we touched on the last video, interval training is gonna keep my metabolism spiked, whereas low intensity, that's just going to burn calories, but your metabolism isn't as spiked afterwards. So for the weekend, I'm simply just keeping my metabolism spiked, burning fat, giving my muscles a little time to rest. Next is gonna be, you're gonna do your whole body through heavy lifting for 3 days. And you're gonna break it up, you know, body parts. So Monday, I'm gonna do legs, full body, you know, sorry, not full body. I'm gonna do legs, but it's gonna be heavy. Normal, like last heavy day for legs. Tuesday is gonna be a push-pull, you know, and you'll notice that the days are kind of decreasing in intensity. So leg day is kind of the hardest. Push-pull is still major muscle groups, but it's not as hard, so that's gonna be Tuesday. Then by Wednesday, we're just doing our last heavy day for arms, so shoulders, biceps, triceps. Again, that's not as taxing. When I say heavy, I mean train like you normally would, just maybe around like 80-85% of what you would normally use. So you're not quite hitting failure like you would have the week before when normal exercise routines. You're still training heavy, just not to your max. Lastly, we get into the end of the week. Now here is where a lot of lifters, they'll cut out working completely and they'll say, oh, that's because I don't want to use up my glycogen. I want to keep the glucose in my muscles. But what's been shown through the literature is that actually, if you don't use the muscle, there's no stimulus for the muscle to be engulfed with glycogen. So any of the carbs you're eating then aren't going to get into the muscle. If you want to get the muscle filled and looking full for the show, you have to keep working it up until the show day, just enough so that there's a stimulus for glycogen to be in the muscle. So Thursday and Friday, it's gonna be like a circuit. It's a whole body circuit, and you go through it two or three times, and it can really be whatever you like. It doesn't have to be any specific circuit, just so that you're working your entire body very lightweight in a kind of cardiovascular aspect. And at the same time, you're going to be dropping your cardio throughout the entire week, so by then it's gonna be only 20 minutes of low intensity cardio at those times. So really just focusing on pumping up the muscle a little bit, getting the glycogen stimulus firing all over the body so that carbs are making it into the muscle, but not using anything to really burn up that glycogen. So quick 30, 45 minutes here, tops. Then your low intensity cardio, that's all you need. The day of the show, you're obviously not going to work out, but it's important to know that you do want to pump up the muscle. And I'll do a whole show day vlog the day of the show that'll go more in depth into this, but just know that two or three times that day, not just before you get on stage, but two or three times that day, you do want to pump up the muscles, again, to move any kind of carbs you're eating that day into the muscle. And that's a big thing that I think people or bro science will tell you, you know, to neglect. They're gonna say, don't eat any carbs, cut out all your carbs and sodium, which we already know is bad because your body's gonna react negatively to that. And again, they'll say, cut out lifting, because you don't want to use up any of that muscle. Again, you're not thinking this through the whole way. If you cut it out, there's no stimulus to put glycogen in the muscle, so you're actually missing out on potential fullness that you could have. So, to recap today's whiteboard talk, we are looking at weight training. You want to keep it heavy going into peak week. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, before your Saturday show, you want to lift legs, back and chest, and then arms. Going heavy around 80-85% of what you normally would, and just shying away from failure, just hitting it hard but not so hard you fail on any of your reps. Thursday, Friday, full body circuit, 50-60% of what you would normally lift, pumping up the body, no more than 30-45 minutes lifting the weights, doing the circuits, and no more than 20-25 minutes on cardio. And then day of the show, pumping up multiple times after your meals to again deliver glycogen to the muscle. Get the stimulus firing for glycogen to be in the muscle without actually burning up the glycogen for energy. And that is how I'm going to do it. And that is how I believe the most scientifically backed lifters approach peak week. So we're gonna give it a shot. But if you're doing a peak week, I highly suggest you give this a try, just because the most current knowledge we have on this subject suggests that this is most likely the best way for a natural lifter to really pump themselves up, make themselves look full and tight going into a show. All right, Monday night. Didn't do a physique update over the weekend. Sorry about that. Got really busy. And this vlog has kind of been a conglomeration of all three of those days, but in short, been a long 3 days. Didn't get a lot of filming in like I wanted to, so I'm lumping them together. And hopefully we'll be back on track with much more in-depth videos Tuesday through Saturday. But there wasn't a lot of variability between these 2 days. It was high carbs throughout the weekend, very high carbs today, and then tomorrow we start weaning them back off. But here's the physique update. Now that I'm a little more carbed up, I think I've filled out more, but I look a little heftier, and especially with that 174 weigh-in, definitely holding a little bit more water, holding a little bit more glycogen. But here's what we're looking like at Monday, so 5 days out. No, wait, Monday. 5 days out? Yeah, 5 days out. All right. So I won't sleep no more. No, I won't sleep no more. I won't sleep no more. No DMT. So I think it looks fuller. I feel a little bit tighter actually too. So we'll just have to see how the rest of this week goes, but I feel like I'm down a lot fat-wise actually. My skin, it feels very like stringy almost, which I know is said to be a kind of the starting signs of being to that really shredded level. So I haven't felt like this in a while, and all good signs. All good signs that we're doing well this week. So it's scary putting your carbs up this high, this close to a show. But I like the fullness. I like the energy. And I'm liking how it's looking in the camera right now. And I think this little last bit's going to come off if we do the rest of these days right. So stay tuned for the rest of those couple of days. And you're going to see how we'll do it right. We're going to come in looking good together. See you guys in the next video.